Hey guys, so I'm continuing work on the vignette for the M4-105 howitzer Sherman for the vignette series. Not much has been done to this thing since last time you saw it, since it's been about maybe 3 minutes since the last time I sat down and looked at this thing. I literally just dumped everything that was on the memory card onto the computer and then just started working again. So it's only been a matter of moments for me, where it may have been a couple of days for you. So what I'm about to do is, before I get too far ahead of myself, after I added the static or the scatter onto the scene and the static grass that you see on there for the moss, I sprayed the whole thing with a hairdryer for probably about 10 or 15 minutes just to dry up most of the standing glue to give it a bit of firm, so it's firm and it's not going to fly all over the place. Now, when you spray the thing with the hairdryer, shit's going to fly all over the place because that's what it does. Making dioramas is messy. Making vignettes is just as messy. I mean, you can see there's stuff like lying on the side and everything. It's all over my bench. So after I'm done, I have to, you know, do a clean. So making vignettes and stuff like that, especially when you're using with loose particulates like that, tends to be messy. So this is still, it's still a tiny bit damp, but the glue is on there and it's holding everything, you know, because it's moist, it's holding everything down. It's not going to fly all over the place now. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some tufts of grass and with flowers in it. These are things I order off eBay all the time from a dealer in the UK. These things are self-adhesive, but I tend to add glue to them anyway, because it just makes it a little bit extra, gives it a little bit extra strength to it. And I usually do it at about this point in the construction of the scene, because it allows me to blend them in. They tend to have sharp edges. Sharp, but by that I mean that the edges of them tend to be crisp, like they're harsh edges. And if you put them on top of static grass or anything like that, it tends to be really noticeable when you do that. And they don't look like they're part of the scene. I've made that mistake on many builds and with these things. So now I add them before I do anything else, and then try to add the grass around them. It's a bit tricky, but it's really the only way I found that it works best. So now, using these is not required. It, you know, with all the how-tos that I do, you know, I like to add the caveat that this is not how you make dioramas and how you make vignettes. This is how I make them. I have no idea what the right way is, nor do I care. This is just how I do it, right? And the only reason I make these videos is in case anyone else wants to give it a try. And that's really it. So I don't give a crap how the proper way is. I just know this is how I do it. I don't need to do anything more than that. So I'm going to add one more. And when it comes to these things, every time I do them, I learn a little bit more, and I learn a little bit more. And it's that process I enjoy. I enjoy figuring it out myself as I go along. I enjoy discovering new little things and stuff along the way. And to be completely honest, the reason why I like doing that, it makes it feel like it's mine. It makes it feel like it's my little discovery, even though it's been done 1,000 times by other modelers all over the place. When I find something, I say, ooh, wow, that's a neat idea. I like that. It makes it feel like I discovered it myself, and it makes it more personal for me, like a little personal victory. And that's important to me when I'm doing stuff. It makes me feel confident. Makes me take more risks. It makes me, it makes me try more things when I do that. And it puts me in the experimenting mood, which is always a good thing. So, you know, it works out in the end. I find my work is better because I'm enjoying it more. So it doesn't matter if, you know, somebody's done it 1,000 times before, or somebody says, you know what, you could try this, or you know what, you could try that. Well, eventually I probably will try that when I get around to discovering it for myself. You know, that's what all of this is. Now, I make the YouTube videos and stuff like that, and so other people see my work, and then they, you know, they offer their 2 cents and stuff like that. That's just the way it is. But to be honest, I don't usually take the advice because it spoils the personal discoveries, right? I like to discover them on my own, right? But that's a personal choice for me. Now, it doesn't mean that you can't do that too. And all I show, well, all I try to show when I do these videos is the basics. And then you can go out and find your own personal things yourself. I don't do the advanced videos. I don't see a point in that because it's like spoilers, right? So, just not my thing, I guess. Right, enough jibber jabber. So, now, the next thing I'm going to do is add some static grass to this. Now, I usually use a couple of different kinds of static grass. And when I find it, I'll tell you. Just a second. I put it in a different container last time, and I didn't recognize it, so there we go. Now, this is supposed to be a fall scene. Early fall, very, very, very late summer. Days where it's fairly cold, so the guys, you know, in the early mornings, it's cold enough that they would wear their warmer clothing. Maybe late September, early October, maybe even late October. So there's not going to be a lot of dark green grass growing. These tufts and stuff like that, they're more of a fall type color anyway, so that's kind of where I'm going. So I'm going to start with some dead looking or dying looking static grass, and this is the 2 millimeter stuff. I'm not going to add a lot of this, I'm only going to add a little tiny bit here and there. So the first thing I need to do is add some glue for it to stick to. At this point, I'm not exactly sure everywhere I'm going to put it. I am going to put it along the side of the road. And I'm going to have to add some more glue to this because it's just about empty. Add most of the static grass I'm going to put along the edge of the road. Not really. What's going on with this stuff? It's not breaking apart. Might be the container is too sticky. That's all right. I'll just use it for this. Put it along the side of the road because grass doesn't really like transition areas. I like shade. It grows well in shade, but borders and stuff like that, it tends to be a little dead. But I'm also going to just put it randomly in a couple of spots here and there just for color choice greener stuff, but I don't need a lot of this. Now, oftentimes I mix this stuff together. To make a blend. But I'm not going to be putting a lot of it on, so I don't really need it in this case. Now, it's been sitting here for a couple of minutes. Now, the way static grass is, basically you apply it and you blow on it. And it stands up. Also blows away the excess. Alright. So that's that one. Now I'm going to add real stuff. This is 10 millimeter static grass. It's much, much thicker. I'm also going to be adding a bit of a mat, pieces of a grass mat. I cut it up basically because it is 12 millimeter and a slightly different color, and it will add both depth, color variety, and texture differences, make it much more interesting to look at. Still had some damp glue on there. If not, I'll have to reapply it. I'll wait a few minutes, so. Added in a couple of layers. Let that sit for a moment. Now this is the grass mat that I'll be adding. It's almost the same color. It's a little bit more brownish, but it has an undercoat of a brownish color, right, that I like. So on edges and stuff like that, it has a nice depth to it. I'm going to add some probably right here, maybe some in this area, and then some here, and probably along the back here. We'll have to see. So just gonna wait and let's see if I can blow on this now. Alright, now this stuff you can either tear it or cut it. Now I'll cut it if I'm going to be putting it in like an area like that. Basically, it'll go in there like that, but it's good for areas that have an edge, right? Because you can see the undercut that's underneath. Now I can either spray the underside, and then tack it on, or I can dip it in puddles of glue that are laying on the thing, which is what I normally do. Normally I don't have to do it right now. I'll make a little puddle of glue with that. And then tear a piece off, distress it a bit so it's a bit random. And then dip it. And then stick it on. Now when it dries, if you can see it on there, you can see like little droplets of glue and stuff like that. Right? All that will disappear as it dries. It'll all just slowly fade away. It's kind of a magic almost. It's kind of nice though. Glue off my fingertips. And I need a little one. Now there's little bits of brown in these mats, and that's why I'm using them. Gives it more of a variety texture. Okay. So that's it for the mat. Now, I'll have to put some matted grass where the tank is driven. This is where the tank is passed. And smooshed all the grass down. Once this dries, I'll add mud over top of it or pigments, depending on if I want to go with a wet look or a dry look. But the grass is all glued together and clumped. You won't see most of it anyway because it'll all be underneath the tank. So it won't matter a whole lot. Okay, now I have a vine here that I want to make. Here's my vine right there. It's just a piece of what's called old man's beard. It's a lichen that grows around here and grows quite naturally. Now, where is my... There we go. I'm going to take some... This is basically sawdust that's been tinted green. And it's a couple of different colors. And I'm going to... spray some hairspray on it. Phew! Smells like an old lady's beauty salon in here. That dry. It takes about 5 or 10 minutes for the hairspray to dry completely, and I'm going to glue it on that wall once it's done. Shouldn't take that long. Alright, I think if there's anything. Oh, the little flowers. I forgot the little wee flowers. These are flowers that I collect from around my house called Queen Anne's Lace. It's a weed, and I've been collecting them because they grow this time of year. And then I collect them and I stick them on dioramas because they don't always need to be dried. As soon as I found my pointed tweezers. You can see them. Nice little clumps of flowers. They look like they're dead and dying at this point because I sprayed them with a little bit of lacquer thinner. a couple of days ago in the attempts of trying to dry them out and kill them a bit. And making them look like they're dying because it's the end of the season. I'm going to stick a couple of these on here. A little bit of white glue. Add color. Now, if I dip these in glycerol, they'll be preserved and they won't dry out. And I can paint them. I can dye them with pastels, or I can dye them with acrylic paints, and I can have all kinds of different colors. So they're a pretty handy little weed. I'm almost out of them now. There's not that many left growing outside, so I'll be SOL until next year. Had I known how useful they were this year, I would have collected a whole whack of them, dried them all out. A little bit of variety. Dry. You are. Yay. Spray the back with a little bit of thin PVA. Dry on there. Now I'm probably going to have a small shrub here and a bunch of small shrubs in the back there, but they take a bit more preparation. Basically I take a different type of the old man's beard and I paint it brown and then spray something similar to this vine stuff on it. And it'll be planted there in the back. And then I'll stick a lamppost back in there. And I'm probably going to have to plant some stuff around the base of that a bit. And then we're very close to being finished. So, and then I can install the tank. But I need this to dry for a few hours, at least 8. For all of the PVA to dry completely. Usually only takes about 20 minutes for the PVA to dry, but I'm going to wait a little longer than that. Might have to put a little bit of static grass in front of that that keeps wanting to lift up. Or maybe a little bit of CA glue under it to hold it down. Right, so I'll let that sit and then I'll come back. Okay, so I've whipped together some bushes here, and I'm going to stick them on here. They're reminiscent of the bit of the vine that's on here, but they're a different color. The leaves are similar, but the vine itself is different. This one here is more of a natural color. And the bushes themselves, they're a similar plant, but they're, the actual material I used to make them. Both of them are a type of old man's beard, but one's more of a long, stringy type, and then the other type is more like a small, short, bristly type, that has little suckers on it. And so I use this type here for like vines and creeping stuff, and I use the other type for making like bushes and shrubs and stuff like that. So now I gotta stick them on, and I'm about to do that now. What I did was I painted them like a couple of different colors. They come like a blonde color. Actually, they come like that, like a bleached grass color when I dry them out. So I paint them. This time I painted them a little bit of German gray, and then oversprayed it with a little bit of kind of like an olive drab color. So it's like a brownish green. And then hit it with the hairdryer to dry it, and then sprayed it with some hairspray and sprinkled some of that sawdust leaf on it, and then waited for it to dry, pretty much. So they're still a little bit wet, but it doesn't really matter for our purposes right now. I'm about to stick them on, so I need some glue first. Now I can either use some of the white glue, or I can use something that's called hobby tack. Hobby tack is like a really, really, really thick paste glue. It's like PVA, but it doesn't dry completely. It stays tacky. It's good for doing, like, if you're making these things, these little static grass clumps of bushes and stuff like that, and gluing them on. They're good for doing the backing if you're making them yourself. I've used it like that in the past. So you can like stick them to like a plastic sheet and you can just pull them off later. I found it useful for that kind of thing. And I use it a lot for temporary holds and stuff like that. So if I'm doing like painting shells and stuff like that, like artillery shells and stuff, I'll do it for that. I also use it for sometimes fixing shrubs and stuff like that, because it's soft. I can work with it for a long time, and if I don't like the way it looks, I can remove it and put it on in a different place. So, but for this, I'm going to use just the regular PVA. So I'll squirt some on there, make a nice little puddle, and to attach this stuff, I'm literally just going to dip it in a couple of places. This one's going to go here. And I'm going to leave it there. Let it sit. Leaves are still a little wet, so they're going to fall off a little. Alright, so that's the first one. And I'm going to put another small one over here. There. Make a little hole. Or maybe a big hole. Didn't quite mean for it to go in that deep, but what the hell. Rest of these, and up the rest, maybe two of them at least. Go back here. One of the good things about the hobby tack is it's extremely sticky. So anything you stick it to, it kind of just sticks really well. So it's really good for tacking things down right quick and having them stick like in unusual places right away. So like for gluing things on the back of a wall like that, it's really good for that kind of thing. It's probably really a good idea for me to be doing it for that, but I'm not. I'm using the regular PVA. You can also use CA glue for that, but I find the CA glue gets really brittle over time, and it's not so good at sticking to porous surfaces, especially somewhat granulated porous surfaces like this. It tends to break free really easily, so I don't really like it much for that kind of thing. I try not to use it very much for it. Okay, so that's it for this now. What I'm going to do now is mostly placement weathering for the tank. The tank itself has dark mud and stuff like that, so that's what's going to go in here. So I've got to pull that out. It's a mix that I had a while ago. It's mostly a clay wash with some Future mixed in with it. Give it a little bit of shine so when it dries it looks like it's wet. Where's my brush? So I'm going to dab this in here. Careful not to drip it anywhere else on the scene. Now, I don't want this to look like it's wet mud. The reason why I'm doing it this way is so it looks like it's mashed down. And I'm going to add a mix that'll make it look like it's a little bit more dry over top of this. So instead of it looking like wet mud, it'll look like churned earth, like just turned earth. And then I'm going to make some sod clumps, and I'm going to stick them in the tracks here and there. So it looks like the tank pulled up some sod chunks as it was going by. So this is just meant to look like it's matted down. Now normally I would hit this with a hairdryer to accelerate the drying process. I can't do that right now because there's too much stuff that's wet on here and it will blow all over the place if I do that. I don't really want to do that. So just pack this down. That. Want some in here for the stream as well. Make it look like there's moisture in there. And then tank road drove over it, pretty much ruining it. I don't have any water effects at the moment. Still waiting for it to arrive, so this little brook is not going to get any wet effects added to it right away. Alright, now. I'm going to have to wait for that to dry on its own, and then I'll come back and add another layer that makes it look like it's matted down. But in the meantime, I'm going to try and make those clumps of sod. So I'll just set that up. Okay, so I'm set up. I've basically taken some of the cellulose that I used to make the base itself, and took a small blob and stuck it on my little pallet here. Now I'm mixing some of the clay wash that I made up for doing wet mud in with it to darken it up so that the color matches on the tank, because I use the same color on the tank. You can use whatever color you want. Once I get it mixed so I like the color, I'm going to add some static grass to it in clumps. No idea if this is going to work. This is an experiment. The idea is to make this look like freshly lifted sod. Now I'm going to take some bits of this. Stick it on the tank. So I'm just trying to make it look like it's torn up pieces of the grass as it was rolling over it. And bits and pieces have gotten stuck in the tread. Actually seen that happen, so I figured why don't we try and emulate it. Take some of this and also put it on the diorama or the vignette so that the two of them match up. Stick one to the hull. Do one on the other side too. All right, that looks suitably flattened. That's kind of what I'm going for. Well pressed and squashed. Stick one to the front too. Just a little one. Oh, it doesn't look so bad. That's pretty much what I wanted. All right, now. Need to put some of these on the diorama itself, or the vignette. I suppose I could probably put little bits of sand in here too. Little pieces of rocks and stuff. I don't think I have any that are dark enough though. I think they'd be too stark. Okay, now, static grass, in there. Let's see what I can do with that. Gonna get the dio. Okay, now take a few blobs of this, turn it up. Make it look turned over. I'm not going to need anywhere near this, near as much of this as I thought. Really don't, this is a definitely less is more. Situation. stick. All right. I need a stick. And a tank. Where is it? There it is. Pretty much what I wanted it to do. Alright then. Alright, need my screwdriver. And we're going to screw this to the base. This will work. I already have the hole pre-drilled, but I don't always get it. I'm not gonna miss. Oh, oh, I got it. I don't want it too tight because it breaks the suspension. Okay. Where's the turret? All right, don't need that, which is unfortunate. I'm going to let that dry, though, because I might be able to use it somewhere else. I don't know. All right, so I got the chunks of sod and stuff. I'm going to flatten some of them out here a little bit. They're sticking up a little high. It's not looking so bad, I don't think. You guys are zoomed in a little bit, you can't see. Alright, that's starting to look like I want it to. Okay, the last thing I do for the construction here, before I do the final look over and clean up, is a little bit of pigments. Find it now. Maybe that. Oops. this, and where's my desert sand? I need to mix those two together. And I need something to mix them in. It's not wet. Never have anything that I need right on hand. Always out of hand. Don't need you. Alright. Mix these two colors together. That's the color I want. Now I need my big brush. Road's a little stark. I'm going to add a little bit of color to it, so I'm going to put some pigments on it. Give it a bit of tone. Just thinking if I want to add any more pigments on there. I don't think I do. I think the last thing we're going to do, though, is dry brush those stones. Gray color. Really don't need a lot of this, just a titch. It's a very small effect. Okay, so I'm going to let this sit for about 2 or 3 hours, and then I will do a once-over, see if there's anything else that I want to do, and then clean it up, and probably call it done. So, be back in a bit. So I think that I'm wrapping this thing up now. I haven't done anything really to it other than I stripped the tape off that was around the edge. I cleaned off some of the static grass that was stuck around the edges and stuff. And I put the wires on, which you can't see because they're way up here. I put the wires on the power pole and then trimmed them and painted them. They're not exactly how I was hoping them to be, but I don't really know what else I would use other than actual maybe real wire. I could probably shape it better, but it'd be a lot heavier, and I don't know if those insulators would actually hold them up because they're just made out of plastic. I'd have to remake the telephone pole if I was going to replace the wire. So they're what they are now. So they're just pieces of styrene rod super glued to the top of the insulators, and then I painted them. That's all they are. I don't have any the realistic water that I wanted to use to do the stream, so you'll have to wait, I guess, for another time to see that, if ever. But for now, it's a dry bed because I just don't have any water effects, so nothing I can do about that. And what else did I do? Oh, I put the shells on. Yeah, these are ejected shells from the, because this thing is using the incline of the hill to provide increased elevation because it's an artillery tank, right? It's using the incline of the hill to provide increased elevation to provide support to, I guess, infantry troops further down the road or whatever. So it's firing, and you know, it's ejecting the shells out through the pistol port here, or the shell ejection port. I think they used it for both, actually. And so they're cascading over the side, and so that's why it's sitting here, in case you're wondering. So that I was trying to make it look like they were actually, you know, so that it looked like they were kind of falling. So there's one stuck kind of precariously right there. Hoping that it looks sort of like it's defying gravity. It's kind of the point, so it looks like it's falling, and the one above it as well. So it looks like, you know, because you can only see the four crewmen in there, so that means that the loader is probably pitching those things out the door. Let's see, what else? What else do I have? Nothing. Nothing else. I didn't add anything else. That's it. So, yeah. Anyway, that's all she wrote. Yeah, so I cleaned up, like I said, the backside as well. And I think, I added a little bit more sod, crushed sod, to the front of the tracks. Give it a bit more, I don't know, interest. Interest value. That's all I did. So that's it. So that's a vignette, and I built it in one day. Everything you saw me do, from where you saw it, where it was unpainted, until now, I did it in one day. So it really doesn't take a whole lot of time to do it. The hair dryer is your friend. It speeds up the building time quite a bit. So once you get the base built and it's dry, everything else, depending on the level of detail you want to go to, and the material you want to use, it really goes quite quickly. Now, you know, there are limitations to that. The larger the scene, the more complicated it gets, the more realism you have to cram into it. When it comes to details, the smaller the detail, the better it is. The little tiny things are what makes all the difference. I could add more to this if I wanted to. I could add different kinds of flowers and smaller flowers, smaller patches of shorter grass, twigs and small bushes sticking out of the ground. I could add maybe an animal hiding in like a rabbit or something hiding in by the rock wall. I could actually add the water to the river. I could add, if I was clever, I could probably add maybe smoke effects to the actual gun, right, firing, if I wanted to. Yeah, so, you know, there are more things I could add if I felt I wanted to. I don't, in fact, want to add those things. I'm happy with the way it is. I don't feel a pressing need to add any more to it. I'm happy with it as it is. So it's going to go on the shelf now and do whatever it's going to do there. So that's it. That's all she wrote. Anyway, hopefully you found the series useful in some way, shape, or form. And yeah, that's it. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.